Good afternoon once again, everyone. This is Tube 87. And to those keeping the Sabbath, I hope you're having still a peaceful and a blessed Sabbath. Now, this video is kind of a follow-up to the video I did about fear a couple weeks ago. And this one is about hope. Because if you are living your life in fear, then you have no hope. And like I said, a life without hope is a life lived in fear. So we have to kind of understand what fear is in a couple of different forms. You know, when it comes to the Father and his word and his will, fear is being obedient, the fear of obedience. And that doesn't mean we do things out of being scared, that if we don't, we do it out of our love for him, out of wanting to do what's right. There's an obedience in that kind of a fear, because I fear doing things that are wrong. I don't want to do things that are wrong or against his will. So I'm glad that I have that reference point from him to know that it is a fear of obedience, because I want to, not because I'm scared if I don't do it that I'm going to be punished. So with that being said, follow me to Proverbs 10:28. That's Proverbs 10:28. And it simply reads, it says, "The hope of the righteous shall be gladness, but the expectation of the wicked shall perish." See, the hope of the righteous is gladness. See, and we understand, as those trying to be righteous and do righteous things and die in that righteousness, we understand that the things that wait for us are so wonderful and so beautiful that we have a strong desire and hope in that. That is a gladness that we should all share. We should hope to receive that. And the expectation of the wicked shall perish. See, the wicked don't expect that they're going to perish. They don't expect that anything truly bad is going to happen to them. You have people running around every day feeling like, "I'm going to just live my life and do whatever I want anyway, because when I die and go to hell, all of my friends are going to be there." But it's a foolish notion, because what's going to happen is they're going to ultimately face the second death. And when it's all said and done, they're going to be obliterated into non-existence after they burn their portion. Remember, Satan's going to burn the longest, and they will burn forever, which means until they don't exist anymore. That's what forever means. We use that term arbitrarily, and people truly don't understand what it means. You know, someone will say, "Man, it took you forever to get here," but they arrive. So forever does have a time limit when used that way. And that's what scripture means when it says that the wicked shall perish or burn forever until they don't exist anymore. The hope of the righteous is gladness. And the expectation, that expectation of the wicked, whatever they're expecting, that's going to be dashed. That's going to perish. It's going to go away. They're going to end up in the second death. Hope is one of those things that I try and instill upon some people's thinking. It gives us direction. See, individuals without hope are just all over the place because they have no direction. Those of us who have a focused hope on what the Father has promised us, it guides our life in a specific direction. This is why we should all have hope, because there is an expectation and a gladness in the things that we hope for. If you don't have hope, you truly have nothing, because you're all over the place. You have no barometer to guide your life. That is a sign of someone being lost and confused and always in constant turmoil, because there's no guide there. Now, that hope and the promises of it has been promised to us by the Heavenly Father himself in his word. See, you shouldn't fear to have a hope, even if it's something you can't see or touch or have right now, because at worst case, it guides your life into something better than those who are wicked are living right now. But have that hope. Now, go with me to Proverbs 14:32. Proverbs 14:32 reads, it says, "The wicked is driven away in his wickedness, but the righteous have hope in his death." We're just talking about this. See, the wicked are going to be driven away in that wickedness permanently, but the righteous have hope even in death. Think about it. It's a wonderful thing to even in death have a hope based on what he has promised to us. You can die peaceably and not be worried. Who wants to die wicked in a wicked state? Go with me to Psalms 33:18. Psalms 33:18. It reads, it says, "Behold, the eye of the Lord is upon them that fear him." Remember, fear of obedience, those who are obedient to him, not those who are scared of him. If you're scared of him, that probably means because you're wicked. So, "Behold, the eyes of the Lord is upon them that fear him, upon them that hope in his mercy." Verse 19, "to deliver their soul from death and to keep them alive in famine. Our soul waiteth for the Lord. He is our help and our shield." So, just touching on hope, it's a wonderful thing. It's a wonderful promise. And it gives so much focused guidance in our life. Have that hope. Fear of obedience. Stay in his will. Remember, a life without hope is a life filled with fear. So, and with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be obedient. This is Tube 87. I'm out.